The first year, there's the required medical neurologic experiences. And then there's 6 months of inpatient psychiatry in 2-3 month blocks. That's really about getting the mechanics of being a physician down. How do you write orders? How do you evaluate patients in a timely fashion? How do you decide what's important and what's not important? That is sort of non-specific to psychiatry. A lot of that is just learning how to manage patients in a hospital setting. And what you learn during your medicine experiences carry over to your neurology experiences, and what you learn on psychiatry carries over to those. And each step facilitates the development of expertise in every subsequent step. So a big chunk of your internship is spent at the VA. Inpatient medicine is done there. Some neurology is done there, as well as all the psychiatry is done there. We have a really nice facility, which is a little surprising. Our applicants come out, we make sure we show them the VA, because there's so many VAs that have a reputation as being sort of dilapidated, rundown facilities, and ours is really, really nice. The second year is about psychiatry, really. You have this really integrative experience that's built in, where there's consult psychiatry, where you have to be able to switch gears very quickly from medical illness, psychiatric illness, to social or familial problems that are manifesting as illnesses. That takes a lot of judgment. You couldn't do that as an intern. You couldn't do it very well. The third year is a continuous outpatient year. It used to be you needed a year, but you could break it up, do it throughout training. But now it has to be a continuous year. And the place that makes the most sense to do that is the third year. And so our fourth year is really just don't take call. It's really, what do you want to do? You get to do that. If it's a reasonable plan that facilitates your education, you can do it. So we have people doing refugee psychiatry. We have people, the last few years we've had a couple of people that only come in on Wednesdays for their seminars and to get their psychotherapy supervision. The rest of the week, 52 weeks a year, they're out in rural New Mexico seeing patients in some rural setting and getting supervision out there and treating patients out there and working with the local medical infrastructure. So we have a huge range. It's much greater than you would expect to see for a city this size. The latest census put Albuquerque's metropolitan area at about 850,000. You wouldn't normally need as much capacity as we have, but Albuquerque is really the only city in the state. So you have a catchment area of a couple million people, and the bad cases in any field, the hard to treat, the interesting, the hard to evaluate cases, end up coming to us. It's kind of neat. We get the advantage of a big city hospital without having to be in a big city.